So next, we will talk about what's called PSSMs, or profiles, or even hidden marker models. So this is basic question: how can we use evolution or multiple sequence alignment to find even more homologs, finding better database searches? And we'll do this in some different ways. We'll start talking a bit about patterns, but mainly talk about profiles and hidden marker models. So first, what is a PSSM? Well, PSSM or profile are intermixed words. But PSSM is often, if you talk often about it without, when you don't have a gap information and don't substitute table information. But it's a position specific scoring matrix. So it's basically for every position in a sequence or in an alignment, you have a scoring matrix. In the same way as a scoring matrix as you have for when you do a scoring substitution matrix between two sequences. And the good thing about that is basically you can use exactly the same dynamic programming algorithms as you do when you use Smith-Waterman alignment or Nibelung-Horn alignments. And why do you want to do that? Actually, because the multiple sequence alignments that we had, as we showed in earlier, contains much more information than you do if you only have single sequence alignments. So that means you can get better alignments and better detection. So let's think about it like that. You have a sequence and you want to align it against the profile. So align, basically the same thing as doing test W, you want to have a sequence and want to add it to a multiple sequence alignment. And this we can do with standard dynamic programming methods. So basically you need to do, what you need to do is you need to determine what is the score for aligning position X in the sequence with position Y in the profile or in the multiple sequence alignment. So there are a number of methods to do that. One of them is developed by Gripskov and McLachlan and Eisenberg in 87. They have using a, they don't have a probabilistic model, but they rather use a sign of score for each position. And they have then some gap cost and basically the score for the position is set to the standard substitution scores for all other residues corresponding to the multiple sequence alignment column. So let's. So basically, you want to align one residue to a multiple sequence alignment, and then you just take the average score of aligning every sequence to that, I mean, that residue to every position in this alignment. So it will be like that. So you want to, okay, what is the score for aligning this A in column 1? So in column 1 here, you have 5 V's. And one F, one I. You want to what is called to aligning a residue A to that one. And that's very simple. It's just a score of 5/7 of having a V aligned to A and 1/7 having phenylalanine and 1/7 to have an isoleucine. So that's an easy score. And you can kind of keep on doing that and use a standard substitution matrix to use PAM 250 or Blossom 62, whatever you want to do. So that scoring is easy. So basically, if you take a position, you want to have 50% isoleucine, 30% threonine, 20% valines, use PAM 250, and the II is 5, IT is 0, and IV is 4. You take 0.5 times 5 plus 0.3 times 0 plus 0.2 times 4, and you have get the 3.3. So you score that. So you save the information, and often you save it in integer form, or multiply by 10 or something like that. For your profile, so it's, then you can just do standard multiple sequence alignment. The science is dynamic programming. And they also use a gap. Often you have some heuristic method for dealing with gaps, exactly like cluster W does. So basically, if you have a lot of gaps, you lower the gap penalty. There's a problem. For instance, if you have one problem here is actually if you have 100 sequences that all have cysteines, you know that it should be not just the same score as having a cysteine there at all. It actually should be much more important. You really want to have cysteine there, because it's conserved in this position, is very important. Or any other amino acid. And the same thing with gaps. I mean, score for deletion in column 2 and 4 will be set the same value. But it's more likely to have a position because you have a gap there. But you would more like to have a gap in position four. So you really have to deal with gaps. It's not obvious to do there. So instead, you can actually use amino acid frequencies. You can basically just calculate ideally if you have big multiple alignments, you don't even need a scoring matrix. You can just calculate how common is it to have a certain amino acid in this position. And you can do a log odds ratio of this one. You can calculate, have a higher score for conserved position this way. And this is what often used in hidden water models that I will come to later.